Good morning.
Good morning.
What a beautiful day God has made for us today to worship Him. Amen. Let us bow our heads. Father, we do thank you for the freedom that we have today to gather here. A building that houses your church. Father, you bless us with so many things, and we give you thanks for that. But we ask right now that your Spirit will come down upon us, enter each and every one of us, and open our hearts and minds to this worship service. May we leave here with your knowledge and blessed by our service. In your Son, Jesus Christ's precious name, we pray. Amen. Amen. Going over the announcements. Don't forget, I'm going to highlight most of these announcements. June 17th through, I'm sorry, June 23rd. Not until the 17th. No, I found out yesterday I can't read, and I can't read today either. I was supposed to buy seedless grapes, and I picked up a bag that said seeded grapes, and I read it as seedless grapes, and I came home. Soup kitchen. From now through June 17th, they'll be collecting the food items that are needed for the soup kitchen on June 23rd. Don't forget the Keystone Summer Smiles program is going to run again this summer. Also, the water W. Craig Post 354 is having a Memorial Day service. And Gumtown Park on May 26th at 10:30 a.m. The annual New Bethlehem Public Library Heart in the Park is today. I'm sure everybody's going to be participating in that this afternoon. Also, we had a meeting last week for the mission trip, and they're in real need for people to go on a mission trip. At the moment, I think there's only four that can commit to going on a mission trip, and they're tossing around the idea right now of maybe postponing it. So if you think you'd like to go, be in prayer about it, and get a hold of Pastor Jody and let her know. Also, most importantly, you'll see in your bulletin there's a little paragraph in there about the parking, church parking. There is a Ford pickup truck that is parked right on the corner of Penn and Lafayette, right in front of the fire hydrant, I believe. You may want to, if it is your truck, we don't know whose truck it is, but if it is yours, you might want to move it so you don't get a ticket. But the New Bethlehem Borough Council has had some complaints about the parking blocking vision, sight distance up and down Penn Street, to being able to pull out onto the road, and there was a girl that was almost hit pulling out here last Sunday. So we're recommending that you park in Rupert's parking lot across Penn Street. Also, next Sunday there will be a charge conference held immediately after the worship service on May 27th, and it will pertain to the sale of the Williams House. United Methodist Women are inviting all women from the church on a trip to Homestead Manor. If you have any questions, see Judy Williams or Linda Sloan. Remember our Bible studies. And also on June 16th, from 2 to 5 p.m., there will be a farewell party for Pastor Joe, Jenny, and the family at Fairmont City United Methodist Church. Upcoming this week, First United Methodist, on May 22nd, there will be a missions meeting at 7 p.m. May 23rd at 6 p.m., there will be a Taste for the Years. I think Debbie White, I have no idea what that is. See Debbie White. Also, choir practice and help handle. Strike that.
It's not your fault.
Not your fault, okay. I'm sorry. Oh, Vacation Bible School meeting, I'm presuming, on May 24th at 6 p.m. And May 26th, Williams House yard sale. Are there any other announcements that I...
But the kitchen committee is downstairs is having a Pampered Chef party on June 13th at 6:30. All proceeds will go into our kitchen, and any orders are appreciated.
The kitchen committee?
The kitchen gang.
The kitchen gang is having a membership dinner.
Pampered Chef dinner. We'd like that too.
You guys are in trouble.
Pampered Chef.
Pampered Chef.
June 13th.
6:30. At 6:30.
Everyone's invited. Thank you.
You're welcome. All right.
Well, trustees meeting, okay, last Monday of the month is Memorial Day. We are not going to meet this month. So there's no trustees meeting this month.
Did everybody hear that? No trustees meeting this month. Okay, join me. Shall we stand? And join me for the call of worship. Let us sing.
Praise be to God.
Who dared to take on human flesh and dwell among us?
Praise be to God.
Who did not turn back in the face of evil and death?
Praise be to God.
Who continues to dance through our lives even now?
Thank you that you have set some
At this time, Lord, we will honor our graduates.
Okay, our first graduate we're recognizing this year is Jordan Brewer. She is the daughter of Bill and Jody Brewer. She attended Mercyhurst University in Erie, Pennsylvania, graduating magna cum laude with a Bachelor of Music and Performance with a minor in Arts Administration. She participated in orchestra, vocal jazz, wind ensemble, horn quintet, and served as Secretary of the National Association for Music Educators. Jordan is a member of the Phi Beta Sigma National Honor Society. She enjoys music, and Jordan plans to pursue a master's degree in arts administration at Florida State University. And she cannot be here today because she is currently at her graduation. Our second graduate is Caitlin Burnett Hawa, daughter of Phyllis and Paul Hawa. Caitlin attended East Carolina University in Greenville, North Carolina, graduating with a master's degree in communication sciences and disorders. And in future plans, she will be working in a doctor's office starting in June or July to begin her clinical fellowship. And she also plans to marry Matthew Brown in October of 2012.
Graduates, as they lead and move forward in life. Table.
Unspoken request. Let's go to prayer. Heavenly Father, you are an awesome God. You bless us with so much. We praise you for this choir, the musicians. We praise you for those that have graduated today. So many have worked so hard to worship you and to serve you. And we do give you thanks for having the ability to do that. We praise you for the success that Jerry is having so far, getting through his treatments. And we do lift him up to you at this moment, that you will give him the strength and the courage to keep fighting, keep going. We give you praise for the new family that has moved in. Father, we can't praise you enough. We always have so many prayer requests, and our praises are always so few. But we try to think of all the things you do for us and give us. And all we can say right now is praise you, Lord. Praise you for everything you bless us with. Father, we have a prayer chain, a prayer list that is very long. We lift that prayer list up to you at this moment. Along with that prayer list, we lift Donna Wells and the family, Carl, Jane Murray and her family, Maxine Byers' family, and all those unspoken requests signified by the raising of their hand. Father, you know the needs. You know each and every individual. We lift them up to you in faith because we know and we believe and we have seen that you answer prayers. Father, we ask that you continue to be with us as we worship you through music. And now we end in the prayer that you have taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you.
So you remain standing in our first hymn on page 158.
Yeah.
come before him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving, and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. For the Lord is good, and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations.
Thank you. Praise the Lord. Praise God in His sanctuary. Praise Him in His mighty heavens. Praise Him for His acts of power. Praise Him for His surpassing grace. Praise Him with the sounding of the trumpet. Praise Him with the harp and lyre. Praise Him with tambourine and dancing. Praise Him with the strings and flute. Praise Him with the clash of cymbals. Praise Him with resounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Jesus, the Son of God, born.
beautiful graduates, children's choir, handbell choir, our hymns, and a sanctuary choir. It has been truly, truly beautiful life. And within that life, the First United Methodist Church would like to recognize Debbie Soltz for volunteering her talents for the sanctuary choir the last 3 months. She has done this graciously, beautifully, and with a wonderful smile.
In Jesus Christ's precious name we pray. Amen.